Gotcha. Well, good morning.
Morning.
Welcome to Maple Grove Baptist Church this morning. It's always good to be in the Lord's house, even if it's raining outside a little bit. While I'm thinking about it, don't forget it. There will be no evening service tonight, so we can get ready for Bible school. Those that need to come and prepare their classrooms, get supplies ready, that will be tonight. So no evening service tonight while I'm thinking about it. And there will be a Bible school meeting after church, immediately following the morning service. So if you're involved in Bible school or are interested in helping, there will be a meeting.
And if you were delinquent in signing up and you feel a little guilty about that, you feel free to show up tomorrow night at 6 o'clock.
We need the help. The more hands, the better. Got a note up here. It says the Golden Agers and Super Singles will have a joint meal on Saturday, June the 8th. That's next Saturday at TC's Grill at 3 p.m. There's a sign-up sheet in the church lobby. It says, since Carolyn had surgery this week, please direct questions to Judy Mills or Carolyn Griffith. So if y'all are interested in that, sign-up sheet in the lobby. Got another note about some box fans. 20-inch box fans due June 6th for the Chilhowie Baptist Center. I seen a few back there when I come in this morning, so let's keep that in mind. Deacons meeting next Sunday following the morning service. June 12th, prayer walk at 9 a.m., business and council meeting. And June 16th, Father's Day coming up, so always remember that. So if I have any other announcements that I've missed, don't see any hands. Alrighty. Prayer requests. See some back here. See some hands. Bobby's got some requests. Yeah, Bible school. Always be in prayer for that. It's a good way to minister and to plant the seed. So, any others? Remember Deborah. Okay. Remember Carolyn in your prayers? She had surgery this week. Kathy and Faith. Okay.
Remember Aunt Dorothy's family. They had yard sale last week, so the kids will not be meeting there to eat dinner anymore. The tables are gone.
I understand that. That's hard, yep. I understand that.
They're ever sunny.
Yep.
And the mama was a little sick. We're sick and old.
We saw Tom Yates this week, and he had tests, and he says he's in remission again.
That's good. Good news. Keep my grandfather in your prayers, as always. Any others this morning? Mac McCain, will you lead us in prayer this morning?
Lord, we come to you today so thankful for being able to get up and come to thy house. Lord, we thank you for the Sunday school class we had this morning. Lord, just let us learn something and apply it to our lives that we can be a better Christian to be. And Lord, be with all these requests and be with Alan in the after service. All these things we ask in thy name. Amen.
Amen. Brother Mike.
All right. Has anybody got any older this week? Anybody had any birthdays? Anniversary? Last but not least, a Christian birthday? Oh, I believe we're going. Little church's not going to be empty. All right. Let's sing happy birthday and then gather in the choir.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday. God bless you. Happy birthday to you.
Come gather in the choir.
Thank you.
hold down there on the front.
How long has it been since you told me?
opportunity to come back out to your house. Just bless the one that's going to come and preach a word. Just give them the words to say. Just bless this offering for the upkeep of your kingdom. Just forgive sins, fail thee. Everything we ask in your name. Amen.
Hearts to God.
they've got a song after these two gals, just come on.
Counts the stars one and all. He knows how the sand is on the shore. He sees every sparrow that far. He made the mountains and the seas. He's in controlling everything of all creatures, dead and small. And he knows my name. Every step that I take, every move that I make, every tear that I cry. And he knows my name. I'm overwhelmed by the pain. Can't see the light of day. I know I'll be just fine. He knows my name. What tomorrow may bring, I can't tell you what's in store. I don't know a lot of things. I don't have all the answers to the questions of a life, but I know in who I have believed, and he knows my name. Every step that I take, every move that I make, every tear that I cry, and he knows my name. When I'm overwhelmed by the pain, can't see the light of day, I know I'll be just fine, 'cause he knows my
hasn't been a bed of roses since I started on my way. And Lord, you know I'm not complaining. There's just something I should say, for I've reached desperation. of you from the depths of my heart. It's not a prayer just from the lips. It goes much deeper than the words. It's not a worthless expression. And I just need to be from the depths of my heart, from the depths of my heart, Lord, I'm calling out to you, for I need you here to lead me. I've done all that I'm trying hard to serve you from the depths of my heart.
Good morning. It's good to be back in the Lord's house today. If you have your Bibles with you, let's turn to Luke chapter number 4. Luke chapter number 4 this morning, and go ahead and stand if you will while we read God's Word. I'll give you a moment to get turned to the Scripture in the place where we'll read this morning. Luke chapter number 4. Again, it's good to see everybody here this morning. It's good to be in God's house. And, you know, peeked outside just a minute ago and it was raining and kind of looked kind of bad outside, you know, but you know what? It's always beautiful in God's house. And being with God's people, being filled with the Spirit of God, what a pleasure, what a place to be that we can experience the Spirit of God. We talked about this in Sunday school. And as soon as Bobby got started, I was like, well, here we go again. God's arranged another one together because I didn't know what he was going to teach on. But this morning, we're going to read the first four verses this morning, and we may touch just a few other verses down below. Luke chapter 4, starting in verse number 1. And Jesus, being full of the Holy Ghost, returned from Jordan and was led by the Spirit into the wilderness, being 40 days tempted of the devil. And in those days he did eat nothing. And when they were ended, he afterward hungered. And the devil said unto him, if thou be the Son of God, command this stone that it be made bread. And Jesus answered him, saying, it is written, that man shall not live by bread alone, but by every word of God. Let us pray. Dear Heavenly Father, we come to you in prayer today. God, just asking you first of all that, Lord, we just want to ask that you be with us this morning. And God, that you have charge of this service. Lord, as we pray today, we pray for the lost. Most importantly, there may be someone here today that's never trusted in you and put their faith in you. God, we just pray that God, the Holy Spirit would speak to hearts and move in lives here this morning. God, we pray today for the many needs of this church and our community, the families that are gathered in here today. We pray, God, for those that are unable to be here. We have many that are unable to come, and some that are sick, and some that are just able not to be here. God, we just ask that you bless them and help them in their recovery. Help them, God, to be able to get back and attend God's house. Lord, we pray for all of those that have suffered loss in their family. They've had death. They've experienced that in the last a little while. God, we just ask that you comfort them and give them hope and give them comfort in their lives. Lord, as we pray, God, we want to thank you once again for salvation. Thank you that we have and can experience the forgiveness of sins, that through the salvation experience, God, we can have an eternal home in heaven. Lord, as we pray today, we want to give you thanks for the many blessings, the answered prayers, and for always being with us and watching over us. God, we pray for this service. We pray for this week. We pray for Bible school. We pray, God, that many children and kids, teenagers, adults, whoever it may be, that God, that throughout this service today or even this upcoming week, God, if they realize that they're lost and need to be saved, Lord, that they would see many souls saved, not just today, but throughout this week, and not just our church. Lord, we pray for all churches as they have Bible schools beginning to start. And God, we pray to see many children and teenagers saved. Lord, we thank you for everything. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Before we get started, you know, we request prayer for our Bible school, but we're not the only church having Bible school, all right? We need to be praying for all Bible schools, not just in our area, but throughout our country, because it is a great evangelistic tool. As we look in the Scripture this morning, reading in Luke chapter 4, in verse number 1, notice two things in this verse that we want to cover. In this verse, before we really get to the topic that God has laid on our heart this morning. First of all, as we see here, notice that Jesus was led by the Spirit. Now, and not only was he being led by the Spirit, but the Bible also says he was full of the Holy Ghost, all right? Now, there's been a few times in my life when the Holy Ghost of God has just overwhelmed me to the point that, you know what, I didn't care who was around. I say, Pastor, have you ever shouted? Yes, I've shouted before. Pastor, have you ever took a running fit before? I've got close. But let me say this to you this morning. If God gets on you, you better follow Him, all right? But I'm saying that for this. There's nothing like the feeling of being filled with the Holy Ghost of God. You say, Pastor, what does it feel like? First of all, it feels like you're so close to the Lord Jesus. And you say, Pastor, what else does it feel like? First of all, you can feel the forgiveness and the love that Christ has. That first moment on a Sunday night that when I got saved, you know what? There was such a burden. There was such a load. All the guilt was gone. Hey, listen, I didn't walk down and sit on the front bench. I kind of felt like I floated down because the Spirit of God was now inside of me. Bobby was teaching in Sunday school, and Jesus told his disciples, he said, look, I've got to go away. Now remember, they were surrounded by God's Son. The miracles that he worked, the healings that he healed with, the dead that he raised up, and all of those things. And he said he was going away. You know what? That would have made me feel bad. That that would have made me feel insecure. That would have made me felt like that my hope was soon gone. But he left for a reason. He told him, he said, I got to go. I must go. And guess what? He sent the Comforter. Amen. And guess what? When you get saved, born again, inside of you is placed that Comforter, the Holy Ghost of God, the Spirit of God, however you look at it this morning. Now remember, as this Spirit is leading Jesus, I want to say this. This is an example for you and I. And not only was He leading Jesus, Jesus was following Him. Now remember, Jesus is God's Son clothed in flesh. Now, let's look at it for this. You say, Pastor, was it a good place for Jesus to be? Now, notice this. The Bible says, into the wilderness, being 40 days tempted of the devil. And in those days, he did eat nothing. And when they were ended, he afterward hungered. Now, this shows that not only was he God, but he was also man. And guess what? His body was hungered. You know what? I've went a few hours, maybe even a half a day, not eating something, maybe a time or two, not just get through the day. And guess what? I get hungry, or hangry, as some people say. And guess what? The body is desiring food because it knows that it needs that food for nourishment. I couldn't imagine being 40 days and then the devil tempting him. Now notice this. The Bible says, he said unto him, if thou be the Son of God, command this stone that it be made bread. Now this is how I look at it. If Jesus wanted to make that stone bread, it would have been bread. But he was God's Son. Now notice this. He said, if thou be the Son of God. Now I want to point this out. I've missed this many times in reading this. He was not doubting that he was God's Son. The devil, Satan, whoever you want to look at this morning, whatever name or title we give him in that, he knows who Jesus is. He knows that he is God's Son. But yet he's tempting him to make that stone into bread. Now I want you to turn with me over to Hebrews, if you will, for just a moment. Hebrews chapter 3, I believe it is. I had that place marked. I might have pulled the paper clip out. But Hebrews chapter number 3. Now notice this, what the Bible says in verse 14 out of Hebrews 4. Seeing then that we have a great high priest that is passed into the heavens, Jesus the Son of God, let us hold fast our profession. For we have not a high priest which cannot be touched with the feeling of our infirmities, but was in all points tempted like as we are, yet without sin. Now, notice this. In all of that tempting that Satan put upon Jesus in that, not one single time did he fail. Not one single time did he waver. Could you imagine being tempted like that? You know what? As a Christian today, we are tempted on a daily basis. We are tempted with things to draw us away from church. We are tempted with things to draw us away from prayer. We are tempted to draw us away from studying and reading and praying with our Bible in that. But notice what else is there. Could you imagine? I thought about this, being there 40 days and Satan putting him through all those things. But you know what? God knew that Jesus would not fail. God knew that Jesus would not go and enter into those temptations. I thought about Job. You know what? We've not used Job in a long time. But what about Job? Remember all that he went through, and not one time did he fail. Notice this. And the Bible says, Now there was a day when the sons of God came to present themselves before the Lord, and Satan came also among them. And the Lord said unto Satan, Whence comest thou? Then Satan answered the Lord and said, From going to and fro in the earth, and from walking up and down in it. And the Lord said unto Satan, Hast thou considered my servant Job? There is none like him in the earth, a perfect and upright man, one that feareth God and escheweth evil. Then Satan answered the Lord and said, Doth Job fear God for naught? Hast not thou made a hedge about him and about his house and about all that he hath on every side? Now remember, in all of this, God's hands was around Job, his family, his servants, his house, everything that he had. Listen, I'd rather be in God's hands than man's hands anytime. Amen. But because when his hands, his hedge is about us in hand, we are in the full protection of God. Did not Jesus say that not a one of us could be plucked out of his Father's hand? Guess what? If you're saved today, you're in his hands right now. I was thinking about over in Luke chapter 4, we're getting to the, that's just the opening, all right? We're getting to the meat of it now. Notice what Jesus did through all the temptations, through all the things that he was going through, and the devil, the tempter, however you look at him, working on him. Notice what Jesus did. And Jesus answered him, saying, It is written that man shall not live by bread alone, but by every word of God. Now, you say, Pastor, what did Jesus do with those with that verse? He put him in his place. And you say, Pastor, how did he put him in his place? He used Scripture. Turn with me to Deuteronomy. Chapter number 8. Deuteronomy chapter number 8. Thought I had that one marked too. Deuteronomy chapter number 8. Dealing with the children of Israel. And thou shalt remember, verse 2 is where I'm reading. And thou shalt remember all the way which the Lord thy God led thee these 40 years in the wilderness, to humble thee and to prove thee, and to know what was in thine heart, whether thou wouldest keep his commandments or no. And he humbled thee and suffered thee to hunger and fed thee with manna, which thou knewest not, neither did thy fathers know, that he might make thee know that man doth not live by bread alone, but by every word that proceedeth out of the mouth of the Lord doth man live. Say, Pastor, Jesus used Scripture on Satan to put him in his place? He absolutely did. Guess what we have this morning? We've got, first of all, if you're saved, you've got the Spirit of God about you. Next thing you've got this is you've got the Word of God. And you know what? As that example that he's talking about with the bread, yes, they are, the body needs to be fed. It needs to be nourished in that. But if you look at it in these two aspects in that, one, the bread was a worldly fulfillment. The bread was something that we need, and our, I guess if you look at it in a worldly type fulfillment, we have to have bread and water to live, to survive, to go through. But spiritually, we need something that is of the Spirit. The spiritual fulfillment comes through the Word of God. And guess what? To have life, we have to have these. And now think about this. Through the Word of God, it is revealed to us that all of us are born into sin, and that we are sinners by nature. and that we need a Savior, and that we need forgiveness. And guess what? Through the Word of God, it teaches us that Jesus came to save sinners. He came to save you and me. And that through the Word of God, when we've accepted Jesus Christ, His blood that was shed for our sins, guess what? When it's applied to our lives, we take upon His righteousness. And through that, guess what? There's a book in heaven. I like that book up there, the Book of Life. Amen. And guess what? My name's been written in the Lamb's Book of Life. And you know what? I told you about my story one time, how that when I worked for John Deere, and they said, everybody that's a current employee, guess what? We're going to put your name in here. And you know what? Man, I've got to get that book. Cost me $120. I've got to get that book so that someday my kids, someday my grandkids can open that book up and they can see where Dad worked at John Deere. And you know what? I was so disappointed. When I got that book, it took me 15 minutes to find my little bitty old scrunched up name. And all it had in there was D. Dot Birchfield. I said, man, what a disappointment. That disappointed me. And you know what? God began to work on me and said, you know what? That's not all there is to it. If your name is written in the Lamb's Book of Life, there's no greater place. I want you to think about that this morning. You've got a name in the Lamb's Book of Life. Satan can't touch that name. He can't blot it out. Hey, listen, it's there forever. Let's look at the Scripture here. You say, Pastor, we need, for worldly type things, we need food but to live. But to live spiritually, we need a prayer life. We need to be involved in a church. We need the Word of God. And most importantly, we have to have salvation. Say, Pastor, what is your most important thing in your life? Some of you may say, my wife is one of the most important things in my life. My kids is one of the most important things in my life. My family is one of the most important things in my life. My church is one of the most important things in my life. But the absolute number one most important thing in my life is my salvation. Because guess what? Without salvation, I'll die lost and go to hell. Amen. Family don't get you to heaven. A name in a church roll don't get you to heaven. Hey, being baptized don't get you to heaven. I've been baptized 3 times. Huh? I was baptized in this church, and I was lost as an Easter egg. Some of you remember that. But you know what matters? August the 19th on 2001, Chris was there, Kim was there, Kayla was there, Christy was there. The Spirit of God touched my heart that night. And you know what? When that Holy Ghost fell upon me that night, I felt the best I've never felt in my life before. I felt a peace that I had never experienced. And you say, Pastor, what was that peace? My sins are forgiven. My name's in the Lamb's Book of Life. And if I die tonight, that'll be all right, because I'm going to wake up in glory. Brother Arkey said something a couple weeks ago when he come to preach. I never understood this until I started preaching. Heard several pastors, several men say that if they ever die, they want to die while they're preaching. I didn't understand that. And then after I got started preaching and the Spirit of God got to running in my heart, and I got to thinking about that, I said, you know what, that's a pretty good way to go. Leave here on fire. Leave here full of the Holy Ghost. You know what? Sometimes we are all alone. Sometimes we are all by ourselves. You know what? There's been many times that Laurie's had to go into surgery. She's had to been put under for something. And you know, I always go with her, and I'm right there with her, and I pray with her before she goes back. But you know what? There comes those double doors in a hospital that you just can't go through there. Guess who's there with her? Spirit of God. Jesus. Stand with him this morning. Brother Mike, come get us a song this morning.
Jesus, being full of the Holy Ghost, returned from Jordan and was led by the Spirit into the wilderness. You know what? Jesus has never led me in a place and deserted me. I've had a lot of friends. I've had a lot of people put me in places I should have never been and then leave me there. But Jesus has never left me. I've left him many times. But you know what? He's always there as we sing.
Page 177, bottom page.
Good to be in God's house this morning. You know, the good thing about the Spirit of God is when we leave here in just a minute and we get in our cars, guess who's with us? Spirit of God. When we get to wherever our place is, a destination, whether it be out to eat or home, at the couch, wherever it may be, guess who's with us? Spirit of God. Amen. I'm glad I've got somebody with me all the time. There's been a few times I kind of slip up. And I'll be traveling or going down the road, and I'll say, well, we're almost there. And Jesus said, well, who you got? Or Jesus, Lori goes, who you got with you? I said, just Jesus. She said, because she says that. And it's a habit sometimes. Well, we're almost there. Well, who's with you? Nobody, just Jesus. Anyway, don't forget our announcements. Bible school, no service tonight. So, everybody, you can have time to decorate and do all the things that we do. Don't forget, there is a meeting here, kind of in this area. We'll congregate here in just a second for Bible school if you're helping. Want to help? Anyway, anybody, we can use anybody, all right? So just kind of hang out, get your directions. I thought she had her hand up. She was stretching. All right, so. But pray for Bible school. Adults, hey, come. You'll have a good time. You'll get to see things. You can participate in different things and have a good time. So don't forget, it's not just for children and teenagers, but the adults can have a good time as well, and fellowshipping and talking. Always plenty to do, so don't forget those things. And next week we'll have our deacons meeting, because our business meeting will be that following Wednesday. So don't forget to pray for all of these things. Pray one for another. Pray for the lost, most importantly. Hubert, will you dismiss us in prayer?
Heavenly Father, we just want to thank you for the many blessings that you've bestowed upon us, God, that you're with us everywhere we go. We pray for our church, God, and every member. we can reach out in this community, Lord, and reach out to the young people, God. We pray you for many blessings, and we thank you.